Okay, now let's move forward, and I would like to call our next speaker, who is going to talk about WordPress performance optimization. Now I would like to call the WordPress Iron Man, Haroon Raja.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Okay, so aap mein se kaun kaun already apni koi WordPress ki sites ya business run kar rahe hain jo ke jiski performance mein aapko issues aate hain, users complain karte hain ke bahut slow hai. I see a whole bunch of hands. Aap log mera aaj focus hai is presentation ka. Working? Is this mic working? No. Okay. So we're going to take a look at the what, the why, and the how of WordPress performance optimization. अच्छा साथ में मैंने मेरी आदत होती है कोशिश होती है प्रेजेंटेशंस में कुछ टू लाइटन अप द मूड एंड जो स्लीपी हेड्स होते हैं उन्हें थोड़ा वेक करने के लिए थोड़ा बहुत कोई ह्यूमर डाल दूं. So what do you call the number of times a webmaster can jump on a trampoline? Who's going to answer this one? Anyone? Bounce rate. So moving on. Achha, title mein toh the what, the why and the how hai. Lekin sabse pehle what se pehle hum dekhenge ki hume ye karna kyun hai. Agar humne iske beech mein performance optimization ki field ko study karna hai, us pe work karna hai, toh kyun karna hai? Uski zarurat kyun hai? और उसमें बात आ जाती है हर चीज एवरीथिंग नीड्स टू बी बैक्ड बाय नंबर्स. इफ इट्स जस्ट समवन टेलिंग यू टू डू समथिंग विदाउट बैकिंग बाय एनी नंबर्स बाय एनी स्टैटिस्टिक्स एनी फिगर्स तो देयर इज नो पॉइंट टू इट. सो वी हैव सम स्टैटिस्टिक्स हियर. नियरली 1/3 ऑफ विजिटर्स बाउंस ऑफ फ्रॉम वेब पेजेस दैट लोड इन 7 seconds और लॉन्गर. दैट्स 33% ऑफ योर ट्रैफिक लॉस्ट बिकॉज दे कांट बॉदर वेटिंग फॉर मोर देन 7 seconds. And under 10% of visitors bounce from pages that load in up to 2 seconds. So that's like 90% of your audience is actually staying on the page or waiting for the page to at least fully load in order to read the content. If your page loads in more than 3 seconds, you will have 22% fewer conversions than pages that load within a second. This is more important in e-commerce sites, but even otherwise, conversion could be anything. A newsletter sign-up is a conversion. Having someone read your article and become a fan of your blog could be a conversion. And reducing page speed by as little as, well, as much as 3 seconds can increase revenue for e-commerce sites by up to 12%. So considering these figures, we're getting the hang of why we must focus on performance optimization. Every single second counts. Ye kuch mazid statistics hai. For every 1 second of slowdown, you will face 3 to 5% increase in bounce rate, 7% loss in conversions, 11% drop in page views, and 16% drop in customer satisfaction. And according to official figures from both Amazon and Google, Amazon for every increase in a second of page load time suffers $1.6 billion, that's with a B, in revenue loss because of 1 second increase in page load time. When it comes to Google, 1 second increase in page load time results in 20 million fewer searches per every single day, not a year. Amazon ka ek year ka tha, ye Google ka per day ka. Mobile pay, it is even more important because mobile pay attention spans are short. You're usually out on the go and saath saath aap information consume kar rahe hote hain, you need it quick. So internet, achha, a lot of people in the world that use mobile pe internet, they're on 3G connections, global scale pe dekha jai. 4G urban areas mein hai, lekin 3G ki, abhi bhi 3G pe reliance bahut zyada hai. And nearly 60% of all users from mobile expect ke site would be as fast as the desktop site, lekin they get disappointed. A disappointed user is a potential user lost. 73% of visitors find the sites to be loading way too slow on mobiles, and most sites on mobile lose half their visitors while the site is actually loading. E-commerce sites pe ye aur bhi important hai. 47% users expect site to load in 2 seconds or less. 40% abandon the site if it doesn't load within 3 seconds. 79% are dissatisfied by performance. And 79% of those who are dissatisfied by a site's performance will not buy from the site again and will be less likely to recommend it to others. And a few other statistics that you can see. Let's move on. Is pe zyada time abhi mazid mein nahi lagana cha raha. So the speedy bird catches the worm. Faster sites mean first and foremost better user experience, leading to higher user engagement, resulting in increased customer loyalty. So customer loyalty build karna sabse zyada important hai, because aapke loyal customers na sirf aapke khud customers honge balki wo aapko dusre customers la ke denge. Simply their word of mouth advertising could mean more to your bottom line than your advertising budget entirely put aside. On top of that, search results se organic traffic sabke liye important hai. Faster pages enjoy better search result rankings kyunki Google considers page speed as a factor. And Facebook as well as publicly announced that wo apni news feed mein faster sites ko prioritize karta hai for the same type of content. So Facebook ki bhi jo news feed mein uska ranking algorithm hai, website speed is a factor in that ranking algorithm. Okay, so a sign of a slow shop is by the time that you reach checkout, your credit card has expired. You don't want to have an e-commerce site that puts users into such a predicament. So the why humne dekh liya, ab the what. What factors actually affect your website's performance? Site slow hoti kyun hai? Jis tarah abhi security wali presentation mein humne dekha tha ki sabse bada insecure site ka jo site ke hack hone ka jo source hai, wo hosting hoti hai. Same is true for performance. A vast majority of slow sites are slow because they are hosted on a poor hosting services provider jinhone purane servers pe purane infrastructure pe use apne ek ek server ko overcrowd kiya hua hai with hundreds of users, and they're just trying to make as much money by volume of the clients that they get rather than providing value to any single client. But then when they're charging $5 a month on for hosting, frankly speaking, isse zyada wo provide karna afford bhi nahi kar sakte. So they operate on the scale, the sheer scale of the number of customers rather than providing quality service to a few customers. Uske baad static sites aur CMS sites mein inherently a difference hai ki static site mein simply aapke static web pages already maujood hain, wo serve hone hain. There is no server processing involved. Web server ne sirf page uthana hai, serve kar dena hai, browser ko bhej dena hai. CMS site mein har request pe aapka jo jis programming language mein, jis application language mein site bani hui hai, uska code run hoga. Jis tarah WordPress ke case mein it's PHP. Then database queries hongi, jisse information retrieve hogi, then uska HTML response banega aur wo push kiya jayega. So CMS sites are inherently slower than static sites. Next aa jati hai code quality. Even for CMS sites, a poorly coded site would be far slower than a well coded site. So in case of WordPress, the theme that you're using, if it's optimized for performance already, jis tarah main WordPress ke liye jo theme use karta hu aur clients ke liye bhi aur apni sites ke liye bhi, that's called Astra. It doesn't even load jQuery. It's so lean and it's so focused on performance. Uske jitne extra features hai wo sab aap uske backend se completely disable kar dete hain, aur wo disable hone ke baad wo apne useless scripts jo hain wo load nahi karte. Lekin a lot of themes, they load so many scripts regardless of the features that you're going to use in the theme or not, ke un scripts ki wajah se aapki site ka size increase ho jata hai, the number of resources they need to load wo increase ho jata hai and site slow ho jati hai. So code quality is important. Multimedia. Usman. Okay. So multimedia mein the number of images, the size of images and the way the images are being loaded, that affects your site speed, and overall web page size obviously affects the site speed. So before we move on to optimizing our websites, let's see the metrics that matter. Page load time is the total time it takes from the instance when you enter the URL into your browser till when the page is fully loaded. Time to first byte, TTFB, is the time that it takes jis lamhe aapne request send ki web browser mein to the time when the server starts to respond. That is the time to first byte, the time till the server starts sending the response to your request. Start render is after the time to first byte, jab first byte aapko receive hua uske baad aur full page load hone tak, jab aapki screen pe page ka actual content appear hona start hota hai, that is the time to start render. Uske baad, achha, isse first paint time bhi kaha jata hai. Uske baad aa jata hai time to interactive. Pehle page load hona shuru hota hai, then right when it starts to load, us waqt aapke jitne page elements hain, wo sare ke sare interactive nahi honge. Aap unme text boxes ke beech mein content enter nahi karna nahi shuru kar sakte. Aap kisi animated element ke upar aap uski animation se interact nahi kar sakte. So time to interactive is an important metric ki agar aapka pura page load nahi bhi hua, to bhi agar uska jo above the fold content hai, wo interactive ho jata hai, to for the user, they feel like, theek hai, site loaded hai, we can start working with it. Visually complete is when aapka pura page completely on screen jis tarah se appear hona chahiye us tarah se appear ho raha hai. That doesn't mean ki page fully load ho raha hai. Some scripts that don't display on the screen might still be loading in the background. And number of requests and page size basically determines all of these things. Ab how do we measure these things, because we can't really work with something that we can't measure. So ye top jo three tools maine list kiye hain, these are the more famous ones. Page Speed Insights hai Google ka, Pingdom hai, GT Metrics hai. Zyadatar log inhi se apni site ki speed and performance measure karte hain, lekin inse zyada important aur useful tools hain jo niche the fourth and fifth ones, Web Page Test. Ye bahut si aisi cheeze real life usage ko perspective mein rakhte hue measure karte hain, jo ke pehle wale teen tools sirf aur sirf metrics ko present karne ke chakkar mein un cheezon ko ignore kar dete hain. Yeah, I think yahan pe isme jo sari details hai wo aap dekh shayad nahi sakenge. This is a waterfall view of a site scanned through Web Page Test, and isme yahan pe metrics sare visible nahi hai sahi se. Well, Web Page Test, for example, lets you specify the number of tests you want to run jinka average results aapko show honge. And it calculates the first time render result as well as repeat view result, jisme aapko caching agar aapne implement ki hui hai, to you get to see ke agar first time page let's say 10 seconds mein load ho raha hai, repeat view mein agar wo load ho raha hai within a second, so that means aapke server ki processing wale jo parts hain, unpe aapko work karne ki zarurat hai, caching is working fine. अच्छा एक और छोटा सा बीच में क्विप, व्हाई डू मॉडर्न वेब डेवलपर्स मेक गुड पेरेंट्स, एनीवन, नो वन, यस,
बिकॉज लेट सपोज they support that wo apne bachchon pe yakeen lagte.
I missed that, I'm sorry. Ah, well, yes, that's an interesting answer for sure. That was an interesting answer, but in this case, because they're responsive. So for your site to be responsive, it has to perform well. Logon ko, users ko, as soon as they enter the URL, aapki site load ho jani chahiye. As soon as they click on a button, jis tarah app mein hota hai kisi, ki aapne button press kiya, nayi screen load ho gayi. It should be that responsive. So it should be like modern web developers as parents. Because as a developer, you're basically parent of the site as well. Wo aapki creation hoti hai, it's like your child. At least main to apni jo sites banata hu uske bare mein aise hi passionate feel karta hu, as if they're my children. So now coming down to the nitty-gritty, the how. First and foremost, sabse important step hai ke for अगर आपने हॉबी ब्लॉग बनानी है, आप लर्न कर रहे हैं वर्डप्रेस के बारे में, आप एक्सपेरिमेंट कर रहे हैं, तब तो इट डजंट मैटर आप कौन सी होस्टिंग सर्विस यूज कर रहे हैं, जस्ट गो विद व्हाटएवर वर्क्स फॉर यू. इसी तरह इफ इट्स आपके करंट होस्ट पे, अगर इट्स हैंडलिंग द सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्रैफिक दैट यू आर गेटिंग, अगर साइट पे कुछ सिग्निफिकेंट स्लो डाउन नहीं हो रहे, आपको पोटेंशियल रेवेन्यू लॉस नहीं हो रहा, फाइन एंड डैंडी. बट एज सून एज यू साइट स्टार्ट्स मेकिंग सीरियस मनी एंड यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग सीरियस ट्रैफिक, then invest in the right infrastructure starting from the hosting level. Infrastructure doesn't just start at the hosting level. Hosting ke server pe jo kuch install hua hai, uske ilawa WordPress ke jo aapke application level pe cheeze install hui hai, that's even the infrastructure. Themes and plugins. You have to research the themes rather than starting to use the first theme that looks like the way you envision your site to be. Because looks can be deceptive. Because of the way it looks, it could be the heaviest theme available. ऑल्सो जो मोनोलिथिक थीम्स होते हैं जिसमें एक थीम में आपको लगता है दुनिया का हर फीचर मौजूद है, देर यूजली हैवी बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. सो डोंट निगलेक्ट द कोड बेस एज वेल, ऑप्टिमाइज योर कॉन्टेंट. आपके कॉन्टेंट की ऑप्टिमाइजेशन में स्पेसिफिकली आ जाते हैं आपके इमेजेस एंड वीडियो फाइल्स वगैरह. कैशियर स्टैटिक कॉन्टेंट, जो आपके साइट्स कॉन्टेंट हर पेज व्यू पे जनरेट करती है, इट डजंट हैव टू गो थ्रू द होल PHP प्रोसेसिंग एवरी सिंगल टाइम. इम्प्लीमेंटिंग a robust caching layer, caching solution at every layer of the website. Ke jab PHP code ek dafa run hua, wo PHP level pe cache ho gaya. Jo database ki jitni queries run hui, wo object level pe database cache ho gayi. Using some solution like Redis or Memcache. Aur uske alawa jo pura HTML page web server ne generate kar diya, wo web server ke level pe cache ho gaya, so that jis level pe ek previously cached response maujood hai, you don't have to go through the whole processing cycle again. Use a CDN if necessary. CDN is content delivery network, jo ki agar aapki global audience hai, to static resources, aapke images, JavaScript files, CSS files, wo unhe unke nearest location se serve karegi. Data center aapka New York mein hai, aur aapke customer base all over the world hai, to aapke Moscow mein jo, ya aapke Japan mein jo customers hai, unhe all across the Atlantic or all across the Pacific round trips nahi lagane padenge to get all your images and all your scripts. सिर्फ और सिर्फ उन्हें मेन रिक्वेस्ट साइट पे भेजनी पड़ेगी, बाकी तमाम रिसोर्सेज उनके नियरेस्ट पॉप लोकेशन से सर्व हो जाएंगे. दैट मेक्स अ बिग डिफरेंस फॉर साइट्स विद अ ग्लोबल ऑडियंस. एंड लास्टली AMP एंड इंस्टेंट आर्टिकल्स. AMP जो है वो गूगल का प्लेटफॉर्म है अलॉन्ग विद सम अदर पब्लिशर्स ऑन बोर्ड, एंड इंस्टेंट आर्टिकल्स फेसबुक का प्लेटफॉर्म है. ये दोनों आपकी साइट को प्राइमरली उसका आपके पेजेस का ऑप्टिमाइज वर्जन बनाते हैं जो कि डिलीवर होता है आपके क्लाइंट्स के लिए. ओके, लेट्स क्विकली गो थ्रू द रेस्ट बिकॉज मेरे पास 5 मिनट्स रह गए. सो फर्स्ट थिंग्स फर्स्ट, इसमें डोंट ब्रिंग अ म्यूल टू अ हॉर्स रेस. काफी चीजें मैंने अभी ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन कर दी है बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द स्लाइड, सो वी क्विकली गोइंग टू गो थ्रू द स्लाइड. DNS मैटर्स अ लॉट. आपका DNS अगर क्लाउड फ्लेयर टाइप के किसी प्रोवाइडर पे होस्टेड है, तो it's gonna change the resolution time from your website's domain to its IP address. Us translation ka time from let's say 200 milliseconds to 20 milliseconds. Even Cloudflare or WordPress.com, jaise jo DNS providers hai, wo 4 to 5 milliseconds mein DNS resolution kar dete hain at times. So web hosting humne discuss kar li. Web hosting mein unlimited hosting jo hoti hai, ek plan leke aap uspe you can run like 50 sites, so obviously those 50 sites would be competing with each other for all the resources, so you have to keep that in mind. PHP 7 is not good enough anymore. Even PHP 7 is not good enough anymore. PHP 7.2 has a big advantage on PHP 7, but when it comes to PHP 5, that's a complete no go. So minimum PHP 7 to must have hai. उससे ऊपर 7.2 इज ग्रेट टू हैव. सेम गोज फॉर HTTP 2 एंड SSL. HTTP 2 इंक्रीजेस परफॉर्मेंस अलॉट, एंड HTTP 2 यूज करने के लिए आपके पास SSL होना जरूरी है. SSL के बगैर ब्राउजर्स HTTP 2 को यूटिलाइज नहीं करते. सो इट्स नॉट समथिंग दैट्स नाइस टू हैव, इट्स समथिंग दैट्स मस्ट हैव राइट नाउ. एंड हाउ टू लर्न अबाउट द राइट टूल्स एंड techniques to use, reviews and Facebook groups. They're your best friend in determining what tools are the most suited for these tasks. Building your turf right, ye jo maine abhi cheeze bataye, avoid themes that have everything but the kitchen sink built in. Avoid poorly coded plugins. Research before picking your themes and plugins. Avoid plugins depending on third-party services wherever possible. अक्सर हम sharing के लिए कोई plugins जैसे use कर रहे होते हैं, जो हर share पे third party को call करते हैं, and वहाँ पे आपकी एक कुछ extra requests जाती हैं. When all you need is just a button locally implemented, statistics आपको उससे मिलते हैं, yes, but you have to see if it's worth the extra page extra requests to get those statistics. Keeping plugins limited to the necessary is also important. बहुत से ज़्यादा bulk plugins आप install कर लें तो that often affects your load time. लेकिन it depends on plugin quality more than plugin quantity. So अच्छा एक और चीज़ है कि you should not fret too much. Okay, time's up. I thought 5 minutes left. Okay. 5 minutes left, right? Doesn't my session end at like 5:20? Okay, ठीक है. So don't fret too much about speed scores. Scores पे आपने worry नहीं करना. आपके लिए जो metrics important है वो page load time है और page size है. Page size को आप optimize करेंगे तो load time automatically better होगा. And load time itself is the core metric that you have to optimize. बाकी these are some things that are suggested by these test results that I mentioned. In fact, जो भी 5 minutes रहते हैं उसमें, I think मैं questions अगर ले लूँ तो इनमें से काफी चीजें answer हो जाएंगी. So, do we have any questions? Yes.
Assalamualaikum. First of all, I just loved this talk. I mean, this was one of the most informative out of all of the talks that I've attended today. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
My question is, अभी आपने hosting के बारे में काफी कुछ बताया, but I want to know specifically that कौन सी ऐसी hosting service would you recommend which is economical and at the same time it is you know fast and optimized.
अच्छा मैं चूंकि खुद होस्टिंग इंडस्ट्री में आई एम वर्किंग इन इट आई हैव माय ओन अपकमिंग होस्टिंग कंपनी बाय द नेम ऑफ हैप्पी क्लाउड वी आर आल्सो स्पॉन्सरिंग द इवेंट सो मैं हैविंग अ स्टेक इन द गेम आई एम नॉट इन द पोजीशन टू रिकमेंड समथिंग ऑन स्टेज नॉर एम आई इन अ पोजीशन टू टेल यू व्हिच वंस टू अवॉइड ऑन द स्टेज व्हाइल ऑन स्टेज बिकॉज ऑफ अगेन सम थिंग्स दैट आई डोंट वांट टू मेंशन राइट नाउ बट मीट मी आफ्टर my talk and I'll most likely help you out to the extent I can.
Thank you.
But generally, there is a conglomerate, I won't name it, hosts owned by that conglomerate are usually not recommended. I can't name the conglomerate right now, many of you might know what I'm talking about. So that's all I can say at this stage. Huh. Pardon? Pardon? No, not yet. Don't tell them I paid you for this.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum
salam. So now my question is why managed hosting is important than hosting like work on your hosting on
yeah, sabko pata chal jayega main aapko bhi paise diye unhe bhi paise diye
no like I have heard about managed hostings and shared hosting so I will have to host my blog as well so that's my query that's my genuine query like I'm confused.
Yeah. If you can manage your server infrastructure yourself to a highly performant extent, if you can optimize it yourself, if you can secure it yourself, tab to aapko kya zarurat hai kisi ko itna extra pay karne to get managed. But if you don't have that skill set and you need a level of service, aapke requirement side ki aisi hai ki unse site pe bahut zyada load hai, site bahut slow load ho rahi hai, clients ko error timeouts wagera ho rahe hai, so then yes, your option is either to bring competent sysadmin on board or outsource it to a managed provider jo ki who will take care of all of these things for you. Achha, so ye hosting ka review jo hai, achha, aapka jo hosting ka question tha, note down this site. This is one of the best hosting review sites out there. I have no affiliation with them, so I can put it out there. Their reviews are unbiased. They don't really rank sites based on the affiliate commissions. And yes, we have one more question. Achha, these Facebook groups, आपको मैं एक एक प्रेजेंटेशन में इतना नहीं बता सकता, आप इन फेसबुक ग्रुप से बहुत अमेजिंग चीजें लर्न करेंगे. ज्वाइन वर्डप्रेस स्पीड अप एंड वर्डप्रेस होस्टिंग, दीज टू एज वेल एज इंटरमीडिएट एंड एडवांस्ड वर्डप्रेस. सो एक और क्वेश्चन ले सकते हैं, टाइम्स अप.
हैप्पीनेस बार जी, हैप्पीनेस बार. ओके
ठीक है ठीक है. सो अच्छा, बाकी जितने क्वेश्चन है वो हैप्पीनेस बार में यू कैन कम जॉइन.